Welkom terug. Juliet Kater van Autisme Suid-Afrika sluit nou ook via Skype by my aan. Hallo Juliet.
Hi Kobus.
Juliet.
Thank you for having us.
Pardon?
Thank you for inviting us to the show.
Oh no, I think it's very important. There's been a huge outcry from several organisations with regards to autism and the lockdown and asking for the lockdown to be relaxed where autism is concerned. Yeah. That's probably because you've been facing some huge challenges.
Yeah, definitely.
What are they?
So the primary challenge with people with autism has been the rapid change in their routines. We're all struggling with this crazy world that we find ourselves in with the pandemic and the abruptness with which it happened. Autistic people thrive on routine and having constructive and controlled routines in their lives that are systematic and consistent and predictable. Then COVID comes along, beginning of March, first diagnosis, then halfway through March, schools close. Towards the end of the March, there's a sudden lockdown. When you prepare an autistic person for a major life change or an intervention to help them transition to a new life phase, it's usually gradual. With this, there was no preparation, it was just bam. And they've got to deal with all this unpredictability. They've got anxiety issues already, or they are anxious, and not having this routine in their lives has increased that anxiety quite a lot. So not having predictability, routines out the window, the communication difficulties are becoming more prominent than were there before. Difficulties with emotional regulation, not knowing how to express themselves. And a further issue that we're experiencing with the parents is with the lack of access to services. A child needs early intervention, and the earlier the better. Now they don't have access to their OTs or their speech therapists. So any delay for that child, now we're going into the second month where they haven't had any interventions. That could cause, on the long-term or long-term consequences, regression in behavior, regression in language and communication skills that may have picked up. So parents are quite anxious. Autistic adults are anxious. We anxious as neurotypical. So you can imagine what it's like when your world's run upside down, where you thrived on predictability and routine, and no longer it's just overnight, everything changed quite rapidly for them.
Is it true that occupational therapists now can work on level 4 with autism?
For the occupational therapists, it's a risk for them as well, because you're working in close proximity to the child. We were speaking to some OTs last week. If they did, they'd have to wear full hazmat gear, not just the masks and not just the gloves. They'd have to be dressed up, kitted out fully. That's going to scare the child in the first place, or the young adult if they're working with the young adults. And the risk of infection is high. So I think the organization is still looking at ways around that. But it's difficult because we do know we've got telehealth options available to us. And maybe that's one of the solutions we can be looking at, where parents can approach the OTs or their speech therapists and medical practitioners and ask them about the possibility of telehealth for that particular child or that particular adult. But I think the risk, the public health risk, as opposed to going to a public health facility and exposing yourself to the COVID, it's a really hard balancing act. I don't think anyone wants to be in those shoes at this stage.
Yeah, one hears the phrase, damned if you do and damned if you don't, the whole time. But are there any solutions? I mean, there are so many different situations in South Africa. Some parents need to go to work and they need to leave their children with autism at home, which I can't even imagine. But is there something that you can tell the viewers that is just sitting with their hands in their hairs to feel better or to maybe, I don't know, get a hint?
So there are a lot of resources that are available and we don't want to reinvent the wheel. One of the first things that we would suggest people do is speak to the autistic adult or the autistic child about what COVID is, communicate clearly and communicate carefully. So it's how you communicate the message about the virus to the individual. There are things like social stories, which it's a visual tool that helps a person to get to grips with a certain situation, how to behave in that situation, and what's expected of them in that situation. So parents don't have to go reinvent or come up with their own social stories. There are loads of social stories on the internet, and Autism South Africa has got quite a lot of resources on their website as well. The other thing that we can suggest is to ensure that there's predictability in the person's life. So keep the routines that you can still keep, but also develop new routines. Keep it simple to start with. A daily routine, for example, we wake up at this time, we're going to wash our faces and brush our teeth, We're going to have breakfast or get dressed before we have breakfast. Very simple routine structures and build a new routine into the person's life that is an element of predictability to reduce that anxiety. For me, importantly, you as a parent or as a caregiver or someone who's working with an autistic person, you need to make sure that you're okay as well. You need to be kind to yourself. You need to take the pressure off yourself. I think Newcastle University has come up with a brilliant guide. I think it's called Uncertainty, Dealing with Uncertainty in Uncertain Times. That resource is also available on our website. It's got suggestions for mindfulness, for relaxation activities. Importantly, is that the person needs to be in the present. We can't do much about what happened yesterday. Mm. We're all very insecure and unsure about tomorrow, but we need to be present for that individual today. The child or the adult, the young adult needs us to be present for them right now.
Thank you, Juliet. Good speaking to you. Nou ja, bekendheid en voorspelbaarheid. Terwyl die inperking almal in Suid-Afrika uitdaag, moet ons nie vergeet dat dit vir sommige mense baie erg is nie. Dit was lekker om weer vanaand uit Johannesburg met julle te gesels. Laat hoor gerus van jou op sosiale media of stuur 'n e-pos, miskien wenke van jou eie situasie na prontuit@aktueel.tv. Volgende maandag aand besoek ons verskeie voedingsskemas en sopkombuise wat help om miljoene honger mense in die land se nood te verlig. Bly ingeskakel vir K en Verslag met Lorenza Eckart net hierna. Lekker aand.